We are all natural time travelers. From the moment we're born to the moment we die, we are trekking across time to witness events around us unique to our period of existence. We watch across our lives, cause and effect, and the progression of time as we see it in our frame of reference. Or you could put it a different way, we are stuck in time travel. And as was said in Star Trek, time is the fire in which we burn. A paraphrase of a line in a poem by Delmore Schwartz. This has led to many notions throughout history. For the Romans, time travel meant a return to happier, more prosperous times. To the modern age, an H.G. Wells envisioning a time machine, or even the exploration of whether time could stop and what it would be like. This paralleled the science of the last 150 years, culminating in Einstein's general and special relativity, which placed limits but also opened up possibilities of time travel. So dream as we might that time travel of one sort or another might be possible, the science of today does allow for some possibilities and some realities regarding it. So here are 10 strange ways time travel could be possible. Number 10. Future. Extreme time dilation. While we know that we are time travelers inching our way day to day into the future, one of the great revelations of science has been that the rate at which you travel into the future can change. This was once thought impossible. In the physics of Isaac Newton, clocks ticked at the same rate across the universe no matter where you were. A wristwatch would have ticked at the same rate, no matter if you were here, or in the Alpha Centauri system, or in a distant galaxy. Then came special relativity, which killed the clocks. The prediction of Einstein was that clocks do not tick at the same rate, but depend on relativistic frames of reference. In short, it depends on how fast you're moving, or if you're in a gravity well, versus another frame of reference where someone is not moving. So the net result is if you set two watches, digital or not, or atomic clocks at exactly the same time and keep one here on Earth, and send the other at high speed through the universe, and then do a U-turn and come back, the clocks will not match when it gets back. This is real. We actually have to correct the GPS system satellites for time dilation, or the clocks get out of sync. While this effect doesn't negate the physics of Newton, that's all still in use, your vehicle, whether a car, plane, or train, must account for it, it does point to Newtonian physics having been incomplete. But there is a huge implication here. The faster you go, the more time dilation becomes evident. In short, given you are already moving forward in time, the universe allows you to hack the rate of time you are traveling into the future, and it gives you two different ways. Yes, if you, as a human living right now, and you want to see what Earth and human civilization will be like in 600 years, far beyond a current lifetime, this universe allows you a way to do that. Just go very, very fast. The challenges of getting up to relativistic speeds fast enough to experience this kind of time dilation aside, it would require massive amounts of energy and a whole lot of engineering. You can in principle do it, but at the cost of the past. So far as we know, or at least we think we know, more on that in a bit, you couldn't ever get back to your own time. But if your past doesn't matter, then you can see the future. Even the very far future, if you get as close to the speed of light as you can. Millions or more years. Number 9. Future. Black holes. Acceleration in relativistic physics is an interesting notion. You'd normally think of it in everyday terms, such as stomping on the gas pedal of a car. But that's not the only acceleration possible in physics. If you think about it, gravity really is an acceleration as well, at least of sorts. When gravity pulls on you, it is in effect imparting an acceleration of you towards the source of the gravity. Even if you're on the surface of that world and not moving, you are still in effect accelerating towards it, at least as the force of gravity is concerned. This means that time dilation also applies here. The more massive the object, the higher its gravity is, and that means an increase in time dilation. This is especially evident in the environment of a black hole, which was more or less shown in an exaggerated form in the movie Interstellar, where time passed at a different rate on the ocean wave world than further out in orbit of the black hole. The reality is that for that to have happened as shown, it would have been required to be hovering just above the event horizon of the black hole, or at least the implied size of that particular black hole. This makes black holes future machines. Spend time near one and time will appear in your frame of reference to tick normally. But in the universe at large, huge amounts of time may be passing in what to you is just a short amount of time. So when you leave the proximity of the black hole, if you can, then you will be in the distant future compared to when you went in. Number 8. Future. Suspended animation. The idea of waking a person up, such as they might be, after a long period of being inanimate is an old idea. Indeed, what is often credited as the first science fiction novel, and for that matter horror novel, at least in the modern sense on that genre, it's Frankenstein by Mary Shelley, and the idea is simple. Grab a bunch of body parts from corpses, including a brain, and shock it back to life and see what you get. Old parts living again, but to not great results, for better or worse. This idea has partly left science fiction and entered reality, at least to a degree, or at least some hope, with efforts to cryogenically freeze people at the point of death, or really shortly thereafter, in hopes of someday being able to wake them up. That's beyond a long shot, but there are ways to envision being able to put humans into some form of suspended animation in order to revive them at a later date. All of the problems with this aside, say it could be made to work. That person becomes a time traveler in effect, having left the present moment they went unconscious to wake up in the future, whatever that date may be. While it may seem like cheating, they'd be spending their non-animation here on Earth with our normal time elapsing, and it still counts just as much as time dilation does. You're just in time out instead of fast forward. Number 7. Past and future. Many worlds. This isn't really a method of time travel, rather a method for making backwards time travel possible. The biggest issue with backwards time travel is causality violations and paradoxes, such as the grandfather paradox. If you go back and convince your grandfather not to have children, you should cease to exist, a theme explored in Back to the Future. But the reality is that it actually depends on one interpretation of quantum mechanics, and it may not be the case. An alternative to it is the many worlds interpretation, where every possible reality splits off into alternate realities. This myriad of alternate worlds can be only slightly different from the one you experience, or they could be radically different. It may be that all paradoxes regarding time travel are solved if the past or the future you visit represents an alternate reality to the one you just left, and time travel really represents a leap between worlds. This was, however, countered by Stephen Hawking, who suggested that even in the many worlds interpretation, a single person should be self-consistent and actually arrive in their own past. An even further suggestion is that if you did travel back in time in the many worlds interpretation by using whatever method, you might end up as a spray of particles, each one ending up in a different reality. Not good. Number 6. Past and future. Alcubieri drives. We often think of the Alcubieri warp drive as a method of faster than light travel. You essentially isolate a piece of space-time around your starship, put a bunch of energy in, and negative mass, into creating a warp field of space itself, which is not beholden to the speed of light, that can move across the universe at whatever speed you want, carrying your ship inside it. The problem is, in relativity, anything that can travel faster than light can in principle travel backwards in time. The Alcubieri warp drive is not immune to this. This is a problem because of an idea originating again with Hawking, the chronology protection conjecture, and it states that anytime you try to build a time machine or anything like one, quantum effects intervene to stop it. In short, the Alcubieri warp drive may be a double-edged sword. If it's possible to use it for faster-than-light travel, you might be able to do it. But once you try to use it as a time machine, the accumulated quantum fluctuations in energy could cause it to explode or collapse into a black hole. There has to be more than a few hard horror sci-fi stories in that one. Number 5. Past. The Tippler Cylinder. So far we've covered future time travel, which in this universe is no big deal, and hints that maybe past time travel may be possible, but ambiguously so. but here we get into actual past time travel possibilities that may exist within the rules of the universe. In this case, we're discussing the Tippler cylinder or Tippler time machine. This one depends on one of two things, infinity and or negative energy. This is a weird one. The solution to the equations of general relativity that spawned this idea were first formulated in 1924 and 1936, but the scientists, Willem van Stockham and Cornel Lanczos, didn't recognize the application to Einstein's closed time-like curves. These are interesting. CTCs represent space-time trajectories that allow you to return to your starting point, consistent with special relativity. This means that you could journey into the future, but arrive back in the past, which might violate causality and might not exist. Frank Tippler recognized this in 1974 and proposed a cylinder of infinite length stretching across the universe and rotating, creating a frame-dragging effect on space-time. The end result is this. If you have a spacecraft accelerating in a certain direction, along one of these can travel along a CTC and end up in the past. But try building an infinitely long cylinder. But if you add in negative energy, you might be able to shorten the length needed for the effect. But we have never seen negative energy and have no idea how to produce it. But it does at least provide a highly theoretical way for backwards time travel to be possible. Number 4. Past, the Antiuniverse. One idea in recent cosmology is the concept of a two-sided universe, advanced by Neil Turok. This idea essentially describes our universe extending out one side of the Big Bang and a possible second universe telescoping out from the other side of the Big Bang. This two-sided approach could involve an anti-universe, where the companion universe to our own is running backwards in time. It's even possible that the backwards in time universe is made of antimatter, accounting for the matter-antimatter asymmetry of our universe. Such a universe with a backwards running clock might be otherwise identical to our own, with conceivable copies of us running in a sort of anti-history running in reverse. If this anti-universe could ever be accessed, a tall order for sure, then it might provide a method for backwards time travel to an identical but backwards universe. The catch here, if it's possible, is that to go there costs you one thing, forward-moving time. By going there, you would experience backward-moving time. Would you make that trade? Number 3. Past, the One Electron Universe. In what must have been a truly amazing phone call in spring 1940, physicist John Wheeler called Richard Feynman, explaining that he had solved the mystery of why all electrons have the same charge and mass. The answer, quite simply, was that they were all the same electron. This novel idea is based on world lines that are traced across space-time by every electron. Imagine it as a huge number of lines representing the existence of an electron across time, or one line connecting you from your birth to your death across your life. But we don't actually know that that's the case for electrons, so Wheeler thought, why not instead of lines, a gigantic tangle, for which we see a slice of it at any given time. Something like if you were to take a slice of a ball of string. Each of the strings you'd see in the slice represent a single electron, or so you think, or a piece of string, passing around the ball. But in the end, they're all the same string. Wheeler pointed out that it could be that half of the lines go forward and the other half backwards, and that the backwards ones represent the positron, the antiparticle of the electron, moving backwards through time. Feynman noted that electrons in the universe seem to vastly outnumber positrons, to which Wheeler hypothesized that they may be hidden within protons. Nevertheless, Feynman did credit Wheeler with the thinking of positrons going backwards in time and wrote further on it. If positrons do represent backwards time travel, it's difficult to see a use for it, other than confirmation that some particles in nature can go backwards, careening towards the Big Bang. While we may never be able to use the effect, should it actually be the case, it does provide proof of concept that the past is back there somewhere, and positrons may be streaming towards it. Number 2. Past and Future, Wormholes and Time. One of relativity's most interesting possibilities is that of wormholes, which consist of gateways through space, perhaps through another dimension that link two separate points in space, but also possibly two separate points in time. Whether wormholes can be created, and the even bigger question of can they be controlled as to when or where the other side leads, are still unknowns. But there are ideas of creating traversable wormholes. The major approach is to envision negative mass, if that's possible to create. This would allow for the creation of a stable wormhole, essentially held open through the use of the negative mass. There are still many questions regarding wormholes, but they do offer one of the more potentially viable ways to travel time in the far future. Number 1. Past. Tachionic antitelephones. This is perhaps the strangest possibility in regards to past time travel options. One of the strange attributes of relativity is that while it states that matter can't ever reach the speed of light due to an infinite energy requirement, and the pesky issue that at the speed of light time stops, it doesn't prohibit a mirror situation that could be happening faster than light. This is to say that there could be particles traveling faster than light that can't ever slow down to meet the speed of light. These hypothetical FTL particles would inherently be traveling backwards in time. It has been suggested that such particles, should they actually exist, might be manipulatable and could allow for essentially a telephone call to the past. You could send information backwards in time, and if anyone could receive it, say you knew about the concept and built a receiver and then just waited for someone from the future to call, then you could in principle receive a message from the future. This of course creates paradoxes, and you'd never have to debate about which stocks to invest in. But here is the odd possibility. If they sent you a genetic plan for cloning a human from the future, you could in principle do it. While not a very satisfying way to time travel back to the past, as it would be a clone and not the original person, it's still a very weird possibility. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.